Very, very special. We're here for the Sri Lanka game at the beginning of the summer, and now obviously for the India Test match. And it's always been iconic. It's always been a very special place, both as a player and as a spectator. Having seen it as a player, it's amazing to walk out leading a team or just playing in cup finals and in one-day internationals for England. So it's still the most special ground in the world. It's no coincidence that England had a poor record here up until a few years ago. Opposition sides play here once in every 4 years, and when they get that experience, they take it with both hands, and they have done. England's record's been better recently, but certainly from a travelling team's perspective, it's always special to come here, and if you're only here as little as they are, then they're going to make it count. Pretty evenly matched sides. Both sides are in transition. England probably got a little bit more experience with the Broads and Andersons and Cooks and Bell than the Indians, but both sides are trying to regrow and regroup and start again in a new generation of cricketers. So two evenly matched teams, really. They've all scored hundreds in Test match cricket, so they've all proved their point and done as well as they could have possibly done in their first three or four Test matches. So they've not surprised me. None of them surprised me. They've done well because they've got good records in first class cricket, and hopefully that will continue to be the case, and England can prosper with those guys and the experience of Bell and obviously Alastair Cook can get back into form. We need him back in form, and there's much to relieve the pressure that seems to be relentless on him at the moment.